The world sees hip-hop through his eyes, was once said about our next guest by DJ Quick. Today, I'm at the compound in the Bronx to talk to photographer Jonathan Mannion.
What is the X factor that you think you have that makes DMX come back and say, let's do five other albums, or Jay-Z?
You know what it is I can articulate my vision. This is my personal and professional work. I love it. You know, I'm a part of the culture since, you know, 88, 89 when I got a hold of it. You know, Big Daddy Kane and the DOC who are up in the show, like, I celebrate them constantly as the people who pulled me in. Like, how can I contribute to this movement? Being an artist and coming from two artists, you know, my parents, like, that was encouraged. And I found photography a beautiful way to have a conversation, to mark a moment that would never be the same again.
DMX, first time you meet him, you always want to get that honest truth about them when you take that shot. How did you get that truth from someone like X, who is, he was new to the game, he probably doesn't know what a photo shoot's even like. How did you guys build that trust where you got that honest shot for his first album cover?
I met him on the set of a 4321 video, Method Man, LL, and Redman. And then he was one of the features on it. And he had some time to kill. I was like, can I borrow you for a minute? Like, let's just go do some dope pictures. So it was me asking for what I wanted in the moment, pulling him, and then authentically delivering something that was connected. I communicate. Like, I want to instantly break past any barriers of ego, of anything. I just want to get straight to the heart and soul of somebody. I photographed him again for The Source. That's an image that's around the corner of him with the dogs that became the single cover for Where My Dog's At. You know, and this was a moment, I think, of him realizing where he was going, the actual trajectory that he was on. You know, he was like literally outside of the window of the expedition, screaming in Yonkers, "Why, yo, baby, why we on, we, for each one of these, you know, moments and images. There's a story like that, yeah, that feels like that. You know, whether it's ODB or Yassine Bey in front of that mural, or Luda at the basement of the GC in Atlanta, first time I shot him, to, you know, Cash Money over here over my shoulder.
So Jonathan, I want to take it back when you were assisting the one and only Richard Avedon. What was that like? What are some things that you've taken working with him that you've taken throughout your whole entire career?
You know, he was doing Versace campaigns, Pirelli calendars, like shooting Gianni Versace, you know, like, I mean, it's crazy stuff, man. And as a 22-year-old kid, you're like, oh my God, like, I was a sponge. The one component, though, that I think stands out to me was his generosity. You know, the generosity of, like, explaining kind of what he was doing. It was never directed, like, let me tell you about this moment. You know what I mean? But if you were there and present for it, like, I would have to drive him out to Montauk to his sort of summer home or whatever, you know, and I'd have 2 hours in the car. And, you know, as a 22-year-old kid, like, you just kind of shut up and you listen.
As a music lover, is there anything that you wish you could bring back? Like, I remember Tuesdays was the day albums would come out. We'd go to Sam Goody, Tower Records. I'm from Massachusetts, so we had Newbury Comics. Like, and you would just be excited to open up that CD, read the thank yous, look at the pictures. Like, do you miss anything that you would want to have come back?
Bring back, like, the proper art of photography, like, as it relates to the tradition. I love shooting film. Like, you had to know that you had the shot. Mm-hmm. You know, you weren't looking on the back of the camera like, look, we got it, yeah, we got it, yeah, we got it, we got it, we got it. You know, it was like, you gotta know it. Like, are you sure you got it? Like, yes, I do.
Does it get annoying? Like, everybody's a photographer now. Everybody got the camera. And it's like, do you feel like, because you've always said in interviews, I had a fight for this. I had a fight for that shot of Biggie at the Palladium. I had a fight for this. So how do you feel with social media now? Everybody's a photographer. Like, do you feel like they're not fighting hard like you did?
It wasn't a fight. It was finding a natural flow and getting into that rhythm where it's unconscious. But I think part of that is also having a skill set that, like, you know, through and through. So I'm never worried about setting my camera. That's like unconsciously happening. It's always about the connection with the subject. I do believe that Drake had a really critical moment of changing the trajectory of music. I photographed him the day before his deal, the day that he signed his deal, and then the day that he went home to celebrate. So this is the moment of celebration. I bought him a bottle of 2005 Opus 1. I asked him to get a Versace blanket, actually. I wanted it to be, this is a moment of So Far Gone, and I just wanted it to be so far away from the understanding of like what people were doing, or thugging it out in front of a car, or standing with the dogs, or like whatever hip hop meant to people, that this was a moment that was left. So I wanted this floral kind of thing, and just to be in the backyard drinking Opus One and chilling. He bought the Hermes blanket instead. Which was really cool. Still a $5,000 blanket. It's crazy. And he was sitting there, you know, just chilling in the backyard, celebrating what must have been kind of a moment of departure for him. You know what I mean? This is like 10 years ago, 2008, and he's just had the run of a lifetime, man. I had to do 10 shots in the day, right? They demanded it was for international press. And thank God I spent that time with her, because I had such a range of the woman that she was becoming and making choices for herself. You know, I'm sure that there was not like an imposed thing, but like, this is your look, and it's sort of the tomboy thing, and everything that everybody emulates now. It's the overalls with the thing with the panties showing, and like, dope, great look. But this was her growing into another level of sophistication, becoming, you know, an actress and having these deeper roles. Like, she was about to explode, you know? And the day was super blessed. The images that I got were outstanding. And it was a really connected moment. You know, I break this down though, and certainly she left us too soon, you know? But it was a moment of understanding that like the time is now, and to not wait. Like, if somebody that sweet and like heartfelt, beautiful, connected with her people, gracious, grateful, classy, can be taken away, like, yo, that's something to pay attention to.
I know you're working on a coffee table book. What about an autobiography? What, you have all these crazy stories. They need to be heard.
I think it begins with the coffee table book. I think that is the opening statement. Put your $100 aside and get ready, because, like, the journey is such a beautiful one. Like, it really does feel, if you were part of hip-hop in the last 25 years, all of them, a part of them, a year of it, or influenced by everything that's happening, this book is going to be a special one to have.